Hello, guys. Wolf! Wolf! Come here, Wolf! Wolf! Buddy! Buddy! Last week, Wolf wasn't feeling right. He had a problem with his stomach. He didn't eat anything for 2 days. He just drank some water, but after that, everything was all right. He began eating a little, and now we're back where we were, eating a lot and barking at Wolf, also in the mood. Wolf! Wolf! So, let's see what we were doing. In the previous video, I was placing all that pieces over here. Also, I have opened up all the holes here, all the port holes. Let me tell you something about that material. This is not wood. This is compressed cardboard. Seems like wood, but it is not. So, when it comes to the bow, you can see, let me focus. You can see how it goes in the bow. When you're going to sand the bow, do it only with paper from 360 and above, and as a finish, use a 600 up to 1000. It's but before doing a lot of finish, just apply one or two coats of sealer, and to make the cardboard to be more to strengthen the cardboard, because if you don't, some of the piece of the cardboard will come apart and will start to peel off. The problem with the construction up to this point is that the entire hull has two coats of sealer, so the filling right here now, it's flat and it's like glass. The wood has no pores anymore. And when you try to glue cardboard over to a glass surface with cyanoacrylic glue, you have a problem because there's no pores in the surface, so the glue will stick on and the cardboard has the ability to observe the glue. So you need two or three tries to do that. It wasn't difficult, it was just time consuming, and in some cases it get you on your nerves. But the result is beautiful. Also, here you have to meet the other side as well. This is flat. I have used in some points some wood putty, as you can see, but it's entire flat. It's like glass over here also. This is cardboard, I say again. So, okay. Nothing will be visible, of course, after the paint is applied. Now, what we have to do? We're just a few steps away from painting everything of the hull, that is. Now, what I see here is that we have place some metallic pieces. So let me get back. I'll get back to you as soon as I'm ready and I have gathered my equipment and materials. So give me a moment for that. One quick correction. I was messing about the ability of the cardboard to absorb. I said observe. It's absorb the cyanoacrylic glue. Sorry for that, guys. So give me a moment and I'll get back to you. Now, guys, I have to cut a lot of these metallic parts, like this here, here, here all this that goes in specific portholes, some of the doors like here, and I have to glue them in specific positions over to the side of the hull, in each side that is. This is not going to be hard, it's going to be time consuming, and just the only problem is to find out where these things must be placed. That's the only problem. So let's do a couple of them together. Sorry for that. Let's do a couple of them together, and we'll see how it goes. We're going to need a Dremel or a small file to be able to make the pieces smooth on the sides where it needs in it, where it's needed. So let me turn the ship around to have a better view according to the plans. Here we're going to place two pieces, knee 7. Knee 7, we have 4. These are the 2 here and these 2 here. So let me separate them. I thought this wasn't doing the job, but it seems that it's fine. Some of the pieces are easy to misplace. Now let's see. One goes over here. And the other one goes over here. Let's do another one. Let's get the piece number 8.
Number 8. This one goes over here. Here, like this. So, let me do them all. There are many, many, many of them. And I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And done. Placed everything. Also opened up holes in everything. These little port holes are 0.8. Here at the doors are 1 mm. And here at the double doors, I used 1.5 mm to open up holes. So everything is done, both sides of course, and now the next step before painting is to place the rudder. For the rudder I'm going to use the two pieces that I've been using for making the spaces between the cardboard pieces and a couple of more. So we will place the rudder together, then I will mask the upper part of the ship, and we will continue with the first coat of paint, black one. It is wise to do it exactly as the plans. The plans say paint everything black, then paint above the black the red. The dark red. That's what I'm going to do, because I want the black paint to cover up all the light bleeding. So this is perfect. I'm going to paint everything black, two, maybe three coats, I will see. And above the black, on the lower half of the ship, there's going to be the dark red. But first of all, we have to place the rudder. So give me some time to gather up my equipment and I'll get back to you to continue. Now guys, let me show you something that I have just found out. Here we're going to make the two propellers, the left and the right. The Titanic had three, one main and another one on each side, so in total three. According to the plans, I have to use these pieces that I were using for the to mark the distances between these parts, and I have to cut a piece, this one, in it's 0.4 millimeters in diameter, and according to the instructions I have to cut it in 60 millimeters in length. This is 60, this is 90. So, as you can see here, we have an extra piece. That means, and according to the photographs, that this piece must be covered entirely by the part that I'm going to make. Here we have the long side of the triangle. This is the short one. In the short one, this piece must be exceeded at 3 millimeters, right about there, let's say, and the rest of it should go over the part, as you can see it doesn't, and end up over here. If I do it with 90 millimeters, you can see that it exceeds and covers the part entirely. So, probably, as you can understand, this measurement is wrong. And I have Wolf here with me that agrees. So, let's make one together, and I'm going to make the other one on my own. First of all, we have to glue this piece. I prefer this one better for now. The other one needs some fixing. I will do that later. I have to glue this piece right in the center of it, over here, like this, with 3 millimeters exceeding over to this side. That's not hard to do, I guess. So let's do it. Some pressure. I have a dead center. I have 3 millimeters that exceeds, and also I have this part that exceeds all over here. This piece goes right here, but as you can see, I need to make it even here to make it flat. It's beautiful. Need some adjustment, I guess. Let me see something and I'll get back to you. So I had to add a small piece, 2 millimeters, to make it a little longer, and now I have to sand the entire piece to make this like the, you will see, like it finishes over there. But I have to sand the entire piece. Thank you.
got it. Perfect. All right, now before gluing, I have to open up a 2 mm hole. We're here dead center. Let's glue. Do remember that we have to glue this over to a surface that has been applied with sealer. That's a little bit hard. It will take some time. Got it. Let me do the other one and I'll get back to you. And done. Both sides. So, what I need to do now is paint the first coat of black and also to mask all the top part of the ship. Don't get it paint over there. So I don't believe that you need to see anything of that, just simple paint. So I will do that and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result of the first coat, that is. And that's it, guys. First coat needs definitely 2, probably 3, and already she looks magnificent and with ochre colors. So guys, from me and Wolf thank you very much for watching, guys. See you soon with the next step.